There are some special right triangles that can help us problem solve even more quickly than using the Pythagorean theorem. If you were able to solve the last problem without using the Pythagorean theorem, then great work. If you didn't, I would go back and check that solution. See how we can do it. For the last problem, we could actually use the special ratio 3 to 4 to 5 to find a missing side length. If the side lengths are in the ratio of 3 to 4 to 5, then any multiple of that would also be a right triangle. So if I multiplied each of these by 2, I could also have a 6, 8, 10 right triangle. We know this is a right triangle since 6 squared is 36, 8 squared is 64, and 10 squared is 100. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So multiplying through by any number for this ratio would give us a right triangle. We could multiply through by 3 to get a different right triangle. And in fact, that triangle would be a 9, 12, 15 right triangle. So by knowing a special right triangle, we can generate an infinite amount of larger right triangles. That's why this ratio is so important. And in fact, it's called a Pythagorean triple. There are a couple Pythagorean triples that appear often enough that it's helpful to know these. If you're able to quickly recognize these, then you can easily find missing side lengths. For example, if we had this right triangle that had a leg of 35 and a hypotenuse of 125 units, what would be this missing leg? Now, you could use the Pythagorean theorem to solve for this missing leg, but I really want you to think about this in terms of ratios. Which of these ratios can help you find this missing leg? Choose the one that you think it corresponds to, and then fill in the missing number based on a multiplier. Good luck.